was living in sin. He bought me from a heartache.
Come on over. What great voices.
Thank you.
Really great to hear them. Who did, and I know the names, but I don't really identify each one. Who did the lead voice on that?
That was my wife, Tremaine.
That was Tremaine.
Yeah.
Ah, very good. Now, how did the family come to be so close-knit that you could all cohere, hang together, and get a sound like that?
Well, I think it goes back to Mom and Dad. Our upbringing. We were brought up in church, but we were also exposed to, my father wasn't in church. He had a very benevolent spirit, but he never stopped us from doing what we were doing. And by us being musicians in the church and the singers, we just kind of hung together, you know?
Sure.
And so that's...
Almost all of the music that you do does have a religious cast to it. You took it seriously enough to become a minister, didn't you?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Now, what led you to a life in the church? Was it through the music or for other reasons?
Well, after we did Oh Happy Day, I got more exposure to different types of people. It wasn't such a sheltered life anymore. And you kind of start to see, you know, the needs of people, that they're the same everywhere. And I wanted to have an appeal that was more than just to, like, say, church people moving from church to church, but, you know, an overall appeal to people in general.
Sure.
And that's what we've got.
Great. Yeah, you sure have. You have small children, haven't you?
Yeah, I have two.
Six and four?
Seven and four.
Well, one of them had a birthday since I got the biographical material. That's one of the things that I wondered is, first I want to ask if do they show musical tendencies?
Oh, absolutely.
My son
is a drummer already.
That's great. Do you worry about them at all in a world that, I don't know whether some of this may be just added publicity, but some of it is real deterioration of some values in our civilization that kind of threaten an erosion that shows that morality kind of is on a downswing. There are counter trends to that, I think, in people's lives, but do you worry about your children growing older and the kind of influences they'll be subjected to in the world as it is? Is that a concern of yours
yet? It's a concern. I wouldn't say that I worry about it. I can't stop my children from being exposed to loose morals or bad morals or whatever. I think, you know, as my parents did, you do the best you can in trying to instill the right principles into your children.
Yeah.
And I believe in the principle in the Word of God that if you train up a child in the way that it should go, then when it's old, then it won't depart from that training. You know, it'll come back, you know. Even if
that's an interesting observation, because some people have said that if you start when your kids are 14 years old or thereabouts, it's too late to start then. There's not much you can do about what they're going to do. Do you think families are, the family itself is an eroded institution? Do you think that's going to survive all right, or do you think some of the sexual freedom and things that are going on in the world are going to erode it further?
Well, I have this feeling, I can't base it on anything other than the fact that I think that we've experienced, you know, an extreme. Mm-hmm. And I think that there are some built-in, I think there's an alarm system built in our conscience that people are going to kind of, you know, they're kind of coming back. We've tried all kinds of religions, you know, and everything that we can do, you know, Broadway is an extreme. There's not too much we can do, but, you know, try to come back and try to deal with a good feeling, you know, a healthy feeling, you know, mentally, you know, spiritually, and what have you.
You think those counter trends then are going to offset the...
I do.
Sort of Gomorrah spirit that is...
I do, yeah.
Good. Well, that's an optimistic view, and I think it's reasonable in this day and age. Are there plans now for the, doing more recording with the...
Yeah, in fact, in February, we're going to do a live recording with the family. We're going to do it at the Oakland Auditorium, two nights in a row, 14th and 15th.
Well,
I think it's going to be great, yeah.
That is good. The proper name now, that was then called the Edwin Hawkins...
yeah. Edwin Hawkins Singers.
But now it's what? Walter and Edwin Hawkins
Walter
and the
Edwin
family.
Walter Hawkins and the family, yeah.
Okay, that's good. Well, that'll fit on a label, that's and a marquee. How about another, could you favor us with another
song? We'd
love to. Good, all right. Harmony seems to be a way of life for the Hawkins family, whether it's expressed in the close relationship which exists among the members of the family or in the beautiful gospel sounds of their performance. Right now, let's listen once again to the music of the Hawkins Family Singers. Just about out of time for today. Until next time, when we hope you'll join us, thank you. So long from all of us on Over Easy.
Be great.